And what you're probably noticed already, there's no ETC in here. And the split is basically we have libs, which is strictly restricted to AEM developers provided content. So it's whatever we ship outside of the box. This should be instance private if by any chance you're thinking about setting up a cluster. And our recommendation is it should be read-only at runtime. So you never perform writes at runtime, only deploy time updates. Then there's apps, which should have the same restrictions as libs, but designed only for customer or integrator provided overlays. Just as before, it should not be writable at runtime by any chance if you want to set it up in a cluster. And it, and that's it. We have conf, which if you remember the presentation on the context-aware configuration, is the global configuration container. Well, not global, also tenant, but yeah. The idea is that the conf is the location of the runtime deployed configurations, so the ones that you can configure at runtime. Otherwise, those should go to libs or apps. Then there's content, everybody knows that. It's the user space, user-generated content. And then there's var and temp, which there's only a small difference between them. We found out that they're mostly system content, not only system content, there's only some user content, but mostly system. The difference is that temp is disposable while var is not. So based on the content categories and the content buckets that we just considered earlier, we built like a very large table with all the category values and where they should put content. And this is just a short example. There's a full mapping in the appendix if you are to download the presentation. So as a short example, if the producer is the AEM developer, and the consumer should be the user, for non-configurations, non-disposable cluster visible content, that should go to slash content. And if the producer is the AML developer consumed by the user, for non-disposable, not non-cluster visible, and non-writable content, that should be libs. And yeah, you have the full mapping at the end of the presentation. So the thing is that structuring the content like this will allow us to do better maintenance and management in the future. This allows us a very good separation of concerns. So we have outside of the box goes to libs. We have integrator stuff goes to apps, and also we have runtime models to the rest of the repository. Either if it's configurations, they go to conf or content or so on and so forth. This allows us to do overlays instead of in-place edits, so we'll not have the clash that I was discussing earlier. Obviously, this avoids overlapping filters because we as Adobe only ship to libs and customer content only goes to apps. And there's also no generic storage locations, so we don't have like an ETC bucket somewhere where you can just throw stuff around and not be sure about what's it about.